إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم اللهم تسليمًا كثيرًا أما بعد. All praise due to Allah and His praise and blessings and peace be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his family, his companions, and his followers until the Day of Judgment. I bear witness that Allah is the only one worthy of worship and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, his last and final messenger. My dear brothers and sisters, during the year, we have heard, mashallah, a lot of khutbas, a lot of reminders, a lot of good advices, a lot of points were raised and subjects that were covered by me or Sheikh Kamar, Sheikh Ibrahim, or any other guest speakers we had during the year in khutbah and lectures and so forth. And I thought maybe in the end of the year, I would like to share with you a random quotes that I picked from statements made or said by the greatest of scholars among the early generations. And some of them even maybe lived in the modern days. But these are random words of wisdom. You might click with one or two of them. You might pick one of two and you feel this is something that, because each one of them is just a gem. It's an incredible advice. It's like a pearl, something that you should hold into it. And I did this to be not in one topic, in one subject, but this is something that you can memorize, you can think about, you can take it. And this is very common. Every one of us should have a couple of statements that always stuck in my head. This is what I always think and remind myself of. It's one of represent how I think and what principles that I hold and what goals that I'm trying to achieve. So I'll start with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu arda. He said once, لا خير في خير بعده النار ولا شر في شر بعده الجنة. There is no any good in goodness that after it hellfire. Yani, there is no good in anything that you might think it's good for you, but it will lead you to hellfire. And there is no, I would not consider something bad, that is something bad I go through it, but it will lead me to Jannah. If it's a hardship and it's bad, maybe it's a sin, but it will lead, after that, the Jannah is the reward. You know, it's a struggle, but it will lead to Jannah. That, I wouldn't call that something bad. I wouldn't call something good. I had a good time, I had a good this, I had a good deal, but that deal will lead to hellfire. Ar-Rahim ant, rahimahullah. Then he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَى مِن بَاطِنِكَ مَا يَرَى مِن ظَاهِرِكَ. Allah see what's inside you as He see what's outside. Umar radiallahu anhu said, من كثر كلامه كثر سقطه. Those who speak, Umar said, those who talk too much, they make too many mistakes. And also Umar radiallahu anhu said, if you want to have a true someone to love you so much and to be so near to you and care for you so much, became like your friend and he loves you or she loves you so much, do these three. قال مما يصفي لك ود أخيك تبدأه بالسلام. Every time you see that person, you greet him or her first. By the way, these are very good advices for us at home too. You start by greeting the person. وأن تدعوه بأحب الأسماء إليه. You call the person with the names that they love the most. If there's a nickname or some way you pronounce that, and they love that name, call them. Don't make fun of their names or call them with names that they don't like. Then he said, وَأَن تُوَسِّعَ لَهُ فِي الْمَجْلِسِ. That every time this person comes, always make a space for that person to sit near to you or close to you. Umar radiallahu anhu arda said, وَيْلُ لِمَنْ كَانَتِ الدُّنْيَا هَمُّهُ وَالْخَطَايَا عَمَلُهُ كَيْفَ يَقْدِمُ غَدًا بِقَدْرِ مَا تَحْرُثُونَ تَحْصُدُونَ. Umar radiallahu anhu said, what a great loser the person that all his or her concern is the dunya, and most of their actions are considered sins. How this person will deal with tomorrow, which is the day of judgment. What you plan today, you will collect tomorrow. You will collect tomorrow. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said once, memorizing the Quran is not by saying it without looking at the Mus'haf. It's not just by memorizing it. It is by applying it in your life. قَالَ لَيْسَ حِفْظُ الْقُرْآنِ بِحِفْظِ حُرُوفِهِ وَإِنَّمَا بِإِقَامَةِ حُدُودِهِ. And he said the worst of type of misguidance, the misguidance that happened after Allah shows you the way. And if you are blessed that Allah gave you knowledge and a reminder and shows you what is right, and he gave you the knowledge, then you choose to go astray, that's the worst type of misguidance. And once he said, تَعَوَّدُ الْخَيْرِ فَإِنَّ الْخَيْرَ عَادَ. He said once, make good deeds part of your habit, part of your routine. Because if you get into the habit of doing good, you will find doing good becomes something very natural. قال في عن الضحاك قال قال أبو الدرداء. شوف الموقف العجيب. أبو الدرداء, he moved to Syria. He was living in Damascus. فقال مرة يا أهل دمشق أنتم الإخوان في الدين. And هو من الجزيرة. Said, people of Damascus, you are my brothers. Because you know, he is Arabs, you know, from Arabia, came from to Damascus. He said, you are my brothers in Islam. وَالْجِيرَانُ فِي الدَّارِ. And you guys are neighbors, even before Islam. وَالْأَنصَارُ عَلَى الْأَعْدَاءِ. You the one who have been fighting with us, the enemy. You accepted Islam, you became Muslim, you're fighting with us, the enemy. مَا يَمْنَعُكُم مِّن مَوَدَّتِي وَإِنَّمَا مَأُونَتِي عَلَى غَيْرِكُمْ. But he noticed that the people of Damascus were not, you know, giving him the attention that he would expect. And he meant by that they're not coming to learn from him. There's a lot of people don't care about learning from him what he learned from the Prophet ﷺ. So he was a little bit, you know, not happy with that. And he started with this soft words. Then he said, what is it? You're not responsible for me financially. Someone else is. مَا لِي أَرَى عُلَمَاءَكُمْ يَمُوتُونَ وَجُهَالَكُمْ لَا يَتَعَلَّمُونَ. I see that the scholars dying one day after another. One after another, they dying. And I don't see the ignorance among you seeking knowledge and learning. وَأَرَاكُمْ قَدْ أَقْبَلْتُمْ عَلَى مَا تُكُفِّلَ لَكُمْ بِهِ. يعني الأرزاق. وَتَرَكْتُمْ مَا أُمِرْتُمْ بِهِ. I see you worry so much about the thing that Allah granted. He gave you a guarantee that He will give it to you, which is your provision. But you don't care about the things that you've been ordered to seek, which is knowledge. قال ألا إن أقواما بنوا وشيدوا وجمعوا كثيرا وأملوا بعيدا فأصبح بنيانهم قبورا وأملهم غرورا وجمعهم بورا. People before you or other nations before you had long hopes, gathered so much, they build so many, but what they ended up, the end of whatever they built, it became their graves. Whatever they collected, they lost it. أَلَا فَتَعَلَّمُوا وَعَلِّمُوا. I advise you to learn your deen. And that's something really very painful, not for Abu Darda only, but for me and for anyone who in da'wah and in leadership position. When we see that the community doesn't care about knowledge, doesn't care about learning. He said, أَلَا فَتَعَلَّمُوا. Learn and teach. الْعَالِمُ وَالْمُتَعَلِّمُ فِي الْأَجْرِ سَوَاءُ وَلَا خَيْرَ فِي النَّاسِ بَعْدَهُمَا. The best in the society and community, those who are learning and those who are teaching. ثُمَّ قَالَ يعني أيضا, one of the beautiful statement, which is I think it's very interesting to apply in your life. Abu Ayyub al-Sukhtiani, who's also a great scholar from Damascus, قال لا يسود العبد. You will not be a true leader until you master two qualities. قال حتى يكون فيك خصلتان اليأس مما في أيدي الناس والتغافل عما يكون منهم. That you need to learn how not to desire what people have in their hands, and you need to learn how to let things go. If you master these two, you will be a leader. You will be a true leader at home, a true leader at work, a true leader in society. But if you pick in everything, if you always looking at what people have in their hand and you desire it, people will not like you. قيل لابن المبارك, can you us in one sentence tell us how can you possess the best of manners? He said, avoid anger. قال اترك الغضب. And Ibn al-Mubarak gave also great advice once. He said, إِيَّاكَ أَن تُجَالِسَ صَاحِبَ بِدْعَةٍ. Don't ever set, attend, listen, learn from an innovator. And I'm saying this because today, we don't care. We just turn on the TV to any channel or any YouTube channel or any speakers. He's a Sunni, he's bid'i, he's a person full of the Sunnah or not, ignorance or knowledgeable. That's dangerous. That's very dangerous for your deen. It is Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala said, إذا وجدتم لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سنة فاتبعوها ولا تلتفتوا إلى قول أحد. If you find a clear sunnah from the Prophet ﷺ, follow it. And don't follow what other people are saying. You know, today you see people know what the Prophet ﷺ recommend you to do, but they don't do it because peer pressure, because it looks different. I'm not gonna look like that in society. I'm not gonna do this, I'm not gonna do that. You know, not all my friends, you know, or somebody told me that this is not right. If that's what the Prophet ﷺ said and you're 100% sure about it, it doesn't matter what other people say or feel or think. وأختم بهذا عن عون بن عبد الله قال كان الفقهاء يتواصلون فيما بينهم بثلاث. الفقهاء used to write to each other these three advisors in the early generation. قال من عمل لآخرته كفاه الله أمر دنياه. If you work hard for your akhirah, Allah will also will take care of your dunya. He will never leave you. وَمَنْ أَصْلَحَ سَرِيرَتَهُ أَصْلَحَ اللَّهُ عَلَانِيَتَهُ. And if you fix what between you and Allah, what you do in private, where no one sees you, Allah will also fix your reputation in front of the public. وَمَنْ أَصْلَحَ مَا بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ اللَّهُ أَصْلَحَ اللَّهُ مَا بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ النَّاسِ. And if your relationship with Allah is good, Allah will make sure that your relationship with others, with people, good as well. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us wisdom and to give us the ability to hear the speech and to follow the best of it. أقول ما سمعتم أستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وبعد. Once Imam Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah said, "Istawsu bi ahli sunnati fa innahum ghuraba." I advise you to take care, to support the people who follow the sunnah, who care for the sunnah, who teach the sunnah. There is only few of them. And that's in the time of Sufyan al-Thawri. So what do you think of today? Qala Sufyan al-Thawri, once Sufyan al-Thawri is a great scholar, qala kalima jameela jiddan, one of my favorite quotes of today. قال اعمل للدنيا بقدر بقائك فيها واعمل للآخرة بقدر بقائك فيها. He said, work for the dunya in the same, in according to how long you're going to stay in it. And work for the akhirah according to how long you're going to stay in it. Akhirah means the hereafter. So how long you're going to stay in this dunya, in this life? Work as much as you like, calculate whatever calculation you're gonna make, but also at the same time, when you go to the hereafter, that's how much you should give it attention according to how long you will live after death. كان الفضيل بن عياض يقول والله ما يحل لامرئ أن يؤذي كلبا ولا خنزيرا بغير حق فكيف تؤذي مسلما. الفضيل بن عياض said, if it is haram in Islam to hurt a dog or a pig, how can it be you, يعني, allowed yourself to hurt a Muslim? If a pig or a dog is haram for you to hurt, what about your Muslim brothers? Aydan, Imam Ahmad rahimahullah was asked, how can the person be safe from people? He's not pessimistic, but he's realistic. He said, تُعْطِيهِمْ وَلَا تَأْخُذُ مِنْهُمْ. You give them and you don't take anything from them. وَيُؤْذُونَكَ وَلَا تُؤْذِيهِمْ. If they harm you, don't harm them. تَقْضِي مَصَالِحَهُمْ وَلَا تُكَلِّفُهُمْ قَضَاءَ مَصَالِحِكْ. You help them and you don't ask help from them. قَالُوا يَا إِمَامْ هَذِهِ صَعْبَةً. Yeah, Imam, that's hard. Yani you can, how can you live like that? And if this is what's going to make us safe from people, that's kind of hard. He said, وَلَعَلَّكَ تَسْلَمْ. And he said, after you do all this, you might be safe from people. Yani that's not even guaranteed that they will leave you alone. قال الحسن البصير رحمه الله تفقدوا حلاوة يعني حلاوة الإيمان في ثلاثة أشياء في الصلاة والذكر وقراءة القرآن. If you want to taste the sweetness of Iman, you will find it in three things. And if you don't find it in these three, there is something wrong going on in your life. You need to work on your Iman. You need to work in your relationship with Allah. These three are when you pray. If you don't feel the sweetness of Salah and the closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in dhikr, when you make dhikr, when you make dua, and when you recite the Quran or listen to the Quran. يقول عبد الله بن وهب المصري رحمه الله نظرت أني كلما اغتبت إنسانا أصوم يوما فكنت أغتاب وأصوم فأجهدني فنويت أني كلما اغتبت إنسانا أتصدق بدرهم فمن حب الدراهم تركت الغيبة. يقول رحمه الله. He said, I have a problem that, you know, sometimes I backbite. I mention people. So I decide every time I mention someone, I'll fast one day. He said, I kept fasting a lot and it became hard for me to keep up with the fasting. So I said, you know what? If I make ghiba to anyone, backbite anyone or say something about someone, I will give a dirham, I will pay money, like amount of money. He said, my love for money make me quit backbiting because I start spending a lot of money. What I'm trying to say, he said this to us, you might think like negative of him, but you should understand how honest this person is, that he's telling you about his own weakness. And I'm sharing this because Abdullah ibn Wahb al-Misri, one of the greatest judge ever seen in Egypt, like one of the best, he's one of the greatest scholars. But he still have this weakness, have this problem. It's not something wrong to admit your mistakes. It's not something wrong to work in your mistakes. It's not something wrong that you do it and you fail and you try it. It is a smart thing to keep trying, and it is a smart thing to keep approaching the problem from different dimensions, different ways. To see what the thing that motivates you, if it's money, if it is this, if it's, to see what's the thing that will work, as long as it's halal. And I will just jump to something I found it also very, very beneficial. A quote from Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah. He said, just to cover many different generations. He said, خَيْرُ الْأَعْمَالِ مَا كَانَ لِلَّهِ أَطْوَعُ وَلِصَاحِبِهِ أَنْفَعُ. What is the best deed, he was asked. He said, the thing that make you more submissive, it make you submit more to Allah. It bring your heart to complete submission to Allah. And the thing that it will also, it will please Allah the most and it will benefit you the most. Once Shaykhna Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala said something interesting, and I will end with this. قال صاحب الحق يكفيه دليل وصاحب الهوى لا يكفيه ألف دليل. Very true. He said the one who follows the truth, just one evidence, one point you make, it's enough. He will say, okay, I agree. Awesome. That's fine. The one who follows his desires, if you bring them 1,000 proof, they will still argue. And that's very, very true. Al-jahilu yu'allam. That's why the ignorant person, you just show them the truth. But the one who have hawa, desires, the one who want to argue, is not about following the truth. This person, need to work on his heart, work on his iman, work on his taqwa. It's not about proving the point to him or to her. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed days to, and in the end, to bless our days. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless this year and end it in good and to keep all of us safe. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect all of you from the evilness of this pandemic and to make, inshallah, the next year it's more, much, much better for you all. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless your wealth, to bless your business, to bless your family, to bless your children and your days and nights. As we come to the end of the year, we realize how, you know, life goes by very fast. I still remember when we started the pandemic and we're, oh my God, we're going to stay all the way until Ramadan. Oh my God, it's going to be all the way until the summer. Oh my God. You know, just, but the days goes very fast. Ya Rab, Ya Rab, Ya Hayy, Ya Qayyum, Bi Asma'ika al-Husna, Sifatika al-Husna, Nasaluka an taqiyana sharra hadha al-waba' Ya Rab al-Alamin, Isrif anna sharra, Isrif sharrahu an abdanina, wa an amwalina, wa an ahlina, wa an dhurriyatina, wa an al-alami ajma'in. اللهم يا رب اشفي كل مريض اللهم اشفي كل مريض اللهم اشفي كل مريض وعافي كل مبتلى اللهم ارحم موتانا اللهم ارحم موتانا اللهم ارحم موتانا اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا اللهم احينا على الإسلام ومسكنا بالسنة حتى نموت وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إن كنا من الظالمين وصلي اللهم وسلم على نبينا محمد وقوموا للصلاة يرحمكم الله.